hooked up. Hey, we got a smallmouth on now. It's pretty cool. We caught like 4 or 5 largemouth on this spot. We just now hooked up with our first smallmouth. Decent one. Oh, there we go. Oh. Nice one. Kind of skinny, but still, it's a nice fish. Choking that Ned worm. Let's go. Please flash your camera. Yeah, so we're just bombing a Ned worm out here on this. There's a buoy out here that marks this long, gradual rocky point. And we're just kind of dragging that along, filling those rocks. Man, a Ned worm is a super versatile bait. We threw up there, we caught like 4 largemouth, and then we just caught that smallmouth. So, you know, it's great for all species. You just kind of drag it along. It's super easy way of fishing, but a very effective way. Now let's see if we can catch another one. So basically what you want to do when you're fishing a Ned rig, you don't want to overthink it. You just want to, you know, cast it out there. What we're fishing here is an underwater point. It's got rock. You know, obviously a Ned rig is going to work way better on a rocky bottom. Missed one right there. So rock is key, but what you want to do is just kind of work it like you would a shaky head or like a tube. Just like kind of just drag it, shake it just a little bit, but feel those rocks that you're coming over. And so the cool thing about these Ned heads is that they have a mushroom. There's a fish on there. Got another one. Oh, another smallmouth. Oh, he's a jumper. What I was saying is they have these mushroom heads, and that makes the worm stand up. So that's super key, is just for that worm to kind of stand up when you're dragging along the bottom. Big jumper. There we go. All right, So here's what I was talking about. That mushroom head just kind of keeps that worm, you know, standing. Now, it threw my Senko off, but what I had on here was a 5-inch Senko that I trimmed about 2 inches off. So I had about 3 inches worth of a 5-inch Senko. That's what I caught this bad boy on. So, man, let's go ahead and turn this one loose, and I'll kind of talk about my rod, reel, and line. Thank you, buddy. All right, so let's talk about the rod, reel, and line here for my Ned rig setup. What I have is an Abu Garcia Villain rod. This is just a 7-foot medium action, just a great all-around, length and action for Ned rig fishing. If I'm fishing like shallower water, if I'm skipping docks, I'll probably use a little bit lighter rod, you know, probably like a 6-10 medium light. But for what we're doing out here, you know, kind of more offshore, I love this 7-foot medium action. I pair that up with a Revo MGX Extreme reel. This is the best spinner reel I've ever used. I love this reel. I got a 10-pound Yozuri braid for the main line. And then my leader is an 8-pound Yozuri T7 fluorocarbon. This is a brand new fluorocarbon line that we're coming out with. Super strong, and you know, it's a small diameter too, so those fish can't see the line. So like I was saying, you know, you gotta throw a little mushroom head, because what's gonna happen is that's gonna stand your worm straight up. And don't get too complicated with the worm selection. You know, you can use pretty much any, you know, straight tail kind of stick bait will work. you know, these are, this is a Yamamoto Senko. And what I like to do is, you know, there's all kinds of different sizes of Senkos, but I like the thickness of the 5-inch Senko. So all I do is, you know, I take this 5-inch Senko, I cut about 2 inches off the top. Just kind of just try to cut it straight off. So there's my 2 inches, that's gone. So now I got about 3 inches of that 5-inch Senko, and just kind of just thread that up, just keep it real straight, and this right here is all you need to catch them. It's kind of a do nothing presentation. It's just kind of hopping around the bottom, doesn't do much, but that's the whole deal with Ned Rig fishing, is it catches those fish that have been pressured a lot. You know, they've seen all the crazy looking baits out there that have a lot of movement. This is really subtle, and it's just a super finessey way of catching a lot of fish.